everybody. This is Teenie Tucker coming to you, thanking everybody for all the nice compliments and words of encouragement on our vocal run part one, vocal segment part one. And you guys have put out so many great words and had so many questions that we started to look at those questions, and I said, well, maybe we should incorporate a vocal part two. So Bob and I got together and we put together a vocal run part two. And it's really to answer your questions and all of your desires to discover more about vocal runs. So before I do that, though, I'd like to share a story with you. Perhaps in 1994, I think it is, when I had a desire to play at the Apollo Theater. And everybody knows the infamous Apollo Theater right there in New York City in Harlem. And I was watching it on television, and I said, you know, I think I could do that. And so I got in my car a couple days later, and it was snow, sleet, rain, hail. But I had a desire to do it, so I got in my car and drove there all by myself. The next day, I auditioned at the Apollo. Line was very long, lots of people trying to audition. Somehow, I was blessed to be able to get up there and audition. And made the audition and went back the next day. Next couple days, I went back, and we had a show. And during the rehearsals of the show, I know everybody knows the iconic Sandman, the one that comes and brush you off when you're not doing real good and the Apollo crowd doesn't like you. And they can be a cruel crowd. So he was telling me, he said, now Teenie, he said, what you need to do is, he said, you start that song off just like it's done, because the Apollo crowd, they like to hear something that they're familiar with. They don't want you to stray away from the song. They don't want you to add your own vocal techniques. They don't want you to add your own runs or anything like that until they actually know that you can do the song. So I started singing the song, and I sung it exactly like it was on the CD, how it was originally recorded, and loved the song, and Stephanie Mills did a great job with it. If you ever have a chance to listen to Home, go listen to it. It's also done on the Great Musical Whiz. And I started singing the song, and then partway through the song, I started to put myself into it, my own vocal runs, my own technique, and how I present a song. And there's nothing wrong with that. We can all do that. Take a song and make it our own. And that was just a lesson for me to say that, you know what, you develop your own technique in any song, and that's how you use that technique, however you want to use your vocal runs. But we're going to talk about a little bit about vocal runs like we did in part one, entitled Teenie Sings Vocal Runs, that's on YouTube. But we talked about adding a run to a song and how you feel the run. That's what we talked about more in that segment. In this segment, I'd like to talk to you more about addressing how you define a run, or how you make it more colorful or exciting with feeling and attitude and emotion. And there is a way that you do that with every song if you know how to make it colorful. It's like a painter that paints a picture, you know, where they're going to put this part here and this part there. And it's kind of like that. But remember now, the vocal runs, as I discussed in part one, is a series of tones or notes that goes from one position to another position. It's like you physically walk or run from here to there. And that's basically what it is. If you decide to make a run in the beginning or the middle or the end of the song, that would be up to you. And basically, you can feel where you want to emphasize your runs, and that just comes with a tasteful feel at the right place. That's all. For example, let's take a look at the last verse of At Last. And I'm just going to talk about this for right now. And I think I really want to emphasize more placing the runs at the proper place. And I decided really to stick with the song At Last like we did in part one to make a consistent point of reference. And that's kind of the reason why I did it. The reason why I decided to stick to this song. When I sing the first verse of the song, I may not choose to do that many runs. I may do my runs in the middle of the song, maybe the end of the song. And the reason why I do that is because I want to build the song. You have to build the song to have a point of reference to say, okay, if I'm feeling kind of mellow in the beginning and then it kind of builds up and I'm getting more excited about the song. It's just building the song, adding more excitement and interest to the song. Like I said before, it's like the painter that makes a painting exciting and colorful and flavorful, you know. Now let's discuss how we can make a run even more effective by placing emphasis on certain words or tones. Think about this. What is the most important part of a word or phrase that you're trying to get across in a sentence? I remember as a kid, my mother say, "No, you can't go outside." And I said, "Please let me go outside." "Absolutely not." That is emphasis, and I got it. I'm like, okay, then absolutely not. I'm not going. So it's kind of where you put your emphasis. What point are you trying to make? Kind of like that. And you may also make use of your dynamics. And when I say dynamics, I mean making a song either louder or softer or lower or more powerful or less powerful, depending on where you are in that song and how you want to display that song with your vocal runs or your particular techniques. So let's try this. I like to demonstrate this because at last, the last part of "at last" says, "For you are mine at last." At last, that man has finally come along, and I've been waiting for a long time. So if you just say something like, "For you are mine at last." No. There's nothing exciting about that. But you might want to say it like this. "For you are mine at last." Thank you, Bob. That's more feeling. And it has a little bit of vocal runs in there. It has some softness and some lower notes. And it's something that you can feel, something that you really get in across and you know. But if you really wanted to emphasize the entire line or the entire bar, you would say something like, "Boy, you are mine at last." Yes. If you noticed, I had more of a run there. Now, many times when I do a song, I kind of like the vocal runs to be at the end of my song, and I like to make it full and big at the end because the listener wants to remember something great. When you read a book, you want that book to be something that you remember at the end of that book. Or if you see a great movie, you want that movie to have a great ending. And so you think, "Wow, that's a movie I might go back and see again," you know. So you always want somebody to come back and hear you sing again, right? So, you know, that's what we have to think of, is that we're leaving a song that has power, effectiveness, something that has a memorable ending. That's what you want. And my ending would end something like this on "at last." "For you are mine, you are mine. For you are mine. That's such a beautiful song, "At Last." Thank you, Bob. Now, if I want you to take away anything today in this segment, that would be to find a feeling in between your song. Where you want to add the color? Where do you want to add the excitement? Where you want to put your attitude, your emotion? Think about that. And that, folks, is what this segment is all about, is vocal runs and some kind of dynamics and techniques and some kind of feel that you may incorporate. Now, I hope that this segment has inspired you to find your own vocal techniques. I love you guys, and I hope to hear from you soon. Many blessings.